the Habs have traded their captain, Max Pacioretty. This has been, you know, a long time coming for Max Pacioretty, traded to the Golden Knights. I actually can't believe it's actually happened, to be honest with you.
Well, it was a while. We were talking about it for quite a while. When these things do happen, you're right. You're like, oh, about time.
Yes,
there's the deal.
Exactly. Here are the details of that. Tomas Tatar, of course, acquired by the Golden Knights at the trade deadline in exchange for 3 draft picks, a first round, a second round, and a third round. So the Golden Knights getting something very substantial back in exchange for him. Here's what George McPhee had to say about his side of the deal.
What we tried to accomplish in the expansion draft was to put a good team on the ice and to get a lot of surplus picks that we will use to either draft our way to a championship or to acquire players that can help us now. And we're doing it. Teams change from year to year. There are some additions and some subtractions, and we've added a couple of players in Stastny and Pacioretty that are very good two-way players. I hope that we're a better team than we were last year. Time will tell.
Last season, there was a request that he asked for a trade, and I will not go into detail, but that's a fact, yes. To get, you have to give, and we're able to get the deal done, and I hope it works for both parties. I really do.
All right, well, Max Pacioretty, the 7th captain traded by the Canadiens since 1968. The first, Chris Chelios, traded to the Blackhawks way back in 1990.
Denny
Savard. Dean Carboneau, look at him, drinking out of the cup. I played poker with him before, true story.
Okay, did you win?
I won a few hands.
Okay.
I won a few hands. I held my own, that's for sure. Kirk Muller then, in April of 1995, traded to the New York Islanders. Not long after that, Mike Keane traded to the Colorado Avalanche the following season.
Yeah.
So a lot of busyness happening for the Habs in terms of their captains during that time. In 96, Pierre Turgeon traded to the St. Louis Blues. How about this one, EJ?
Yeah, Vincent Danfous traded to the San Jose Sharks in 1999.
And then, of course, most recently, Max Pacioretty, the 7th captain to be traded since 1968. Going to the Vegas Golden Knights as they try to follow up what was an incredible inaugural season for the Vegas Golden Knights. And obviously, Max Pacioretty is a huge addition to add to that roster. What do you think that does for the Vegas Golden Knights?
Well, it's interesting, right? Because the offseason, George McPhee just said it in that tape, right? People come, people go. And they've had David Perron leave. They've had James Neal leave. And James Neal's the guy I would circle here because very similar players, really, Dave, to Max Pacioretty and James Neal. They're goal-scoring wingers, both left shot. Max Pacioretty is a little younger. He's about 14 months younger than James Neal. And in the end, they end up getting contracts that are roughly the same amount of total dollars. I think it's $28.5, I believe it was, for Neal over 5 years. And it's going to be $28 even over 4 years over Pacioretty. But George McPhee likes, I would say, that 14-month window, a little younger, maybe a little more productivity. He'll benefit there, and I would think he's got to be thrilled just to be having a fresh start, right, Dave?
You know what? I would suggest at this point that Max is just so happy to get a fresh start.
Yeah.
Here's a guy, though, who really loved the city of Montreal. Mm-hmm. Max Pacioretty really embraced what it meant to be a Montreal Canadian. When he became the captain of the team, he really got into the history of the team. He has told me that one of the favorite photographs that he has in his home is of Yvan Cornway and Jean Béliveau going down the stairs in his home. So he's going to take that photograph, I'm sure, to Las Vegas now. But it's a very difficult thing for him. In that, you know, he did love the city as much as he did, but again, the fresh start is huge. And let's face it, this was really the largest elephant in the room in Montreal. I don't think there was any possible way that he could have started the season in Montreal, given what the dynamic was and given the pressure and given all the attention to this.
And I want to ask you, because you're so close to that team and to this story, and by the way, Pacioretty signs a 4-year extension with the Golden Knights following that trade as well. But, you know, we heard Marc Bergevin talk about him requesting a trade, and there's been a lot of talk about that relationship. From your standpoint, is it a sour relationship between those two, or do you think that's just sort of how it's perceived from the outside?
Jackie, I think it depends on who you're listening to, because, of course, Bergevin and Jeff Molson today at the Canadiens Golf Tournament were saying that, yes, Pacioretty had requested a trade. Pacioretty's agent has absolutely vociferously denied that, said, no, he never, ever, ever requested a trade. So I don't know. The truth is out there somewhere. We will probably
somewhere
know.
In the middle.
Exactly.
Well, you know, one thing about that is that Alan Walsh, who was the agent in this case, He has recently come onto the scene for Max Pacioretty. Remember, right. Pacioretty relieved, I think it was CAA, of their duties as his agent. That he brought in Alan Walsh right around the time of the draft.
Right.
So for Alan Walsh, maybe accurate in saying that we never requested a trade because during his time as Pacioretty's agent, they probably didn't. It was already well down that road.
Yeah.
It was probably prior to Alan taking over.
There,
yeah,
exactly.
So I think that's probably where it's at. But
when the puck drops to, it's not going to matter.
I mean,
did he request a trade?
Yeah,
or not?
That's semantics.
He's going to go out.
Right.
He'll play hockey to the best that he can, and Tomas Tatar will come to Montreal and he'll do the best that he can, and then we'll see. If no one can say who's won this trade, because until you drop the puck and you get some idea,
yeah.
You get a season under these guys' skates in their new uniforms, you're not going to know.
And I think it's a good deal for the Canadiens, considering the situation that they were in. Dave and I talked about it a little bit before the show today, is that, you know, they put themselves in a kind of a tough spot here. And they've done that with a number of things that have happened in Montreal over the last couple of years. We saw with Jeff Skinner what the Carolina Hurricanes were able to do with a player that everybody knew they were going to move. They couldn't get much back. In this case, the Montreal Canadiens get Tomas Tatar, who is a reliable player. He's not a great player, but he'll come in and help you. They get Nick Suzuki, who is a first-round draft pick of the Golden Knights. And I think that'll be the key for this deal from the Montreal side, is can Suzuki come in at some point in time over the next year or two and be a helpful player? If he can, if Tatar plays well, and then they use that second-round pick wisely, for the Montreal Canadiens, they can move forward now and try to continue this rebuild as they try to kind of move away from what's been a tough couple of years. So I think for the Canadiens, they did okay considering the circumstances.
Yeah, I mean, to your point, it's hard to win a poker hand when the other person knows what you have, right? And
yeah.
That's sort of the situation that the Montreal Canadiens were in terms of Max Pacioretty. But one way or another, it's a fresh start for Pacioretty. And no matter what, when you're the captain of a team like the Montreal Canadiens, you go down in history. Not to mention, he's on this list, surrounded by elite company, of most seasons with 30 or more goals in franchise history with the Habs.